IVF has been a blessing for a lot of women not able to conceive naturally. But let us talk about the risks of IVF to your health as a woman and a potential child. Simply put, IVF, otherwise known as in vitro fertilization, involves the transfer of the mother's eggs from the ovaries outside the womb to be fertilized with the sperm in a tube. This fertilized egg is now an embryo, which is then transferred back into the body, or in some cases, frozen for future use. However, this is not as easy as it sounds, as the IVF journey can be a long, expensive, arduous, emotional, and frustrating process for couples. So counseling is absolutely necessary for any couple going through IVF. Now let's get straight into the risks. Failed IVF. There is no guarantee that IVF would result in a successful pregnancy. And in fact, many women have gone through 12 or more rounds of IVF only to not be pregnant or miscarry. This could be due to any number of reasons, from the quality of the eggs to the health of the womb. For example, if you had endometriosis. I would advise to avoid any clinics, UK or abroad, that advertise a 50% and above rate, as success rates vary from clinic to clinic and can be as low as 37% or higher, depending on your number of cycles. You will find in most cases, pregnancy rates are quoted as opposed to actual successful pregnancy rates. This is because miscarriages or stillbirth can occur at any stage of pregnancy, so it's important to know the actual live birth rates. Multiple births. This can occur when you have more than one embryo transferred to the womb. And while most women are more than happy to have one child, you can end up with any number from twins to quintuplets. This of course has financial implications for the home and society, especially as you had never planned for the extra rooms or a 9-seater van. There is also the risk of miscarriages, premature births, birth defects, not to mention the health risks to the mother, such as preeclampsia and excessive bleeding. Transferring any more than two embryos in any round of IVF is considered dangerous. Ectopic pregnancy. This occurs when the egg is stuck in the fallopian tube, so the embryo implants in the tube rather than in the womb. The risk is greater if you have a damaged or partly blocked fallopian tube. This can show up on a 6-week scan, but if you have any pelvic pain or bleeding before you scan, then seek urgent help, as an ectopic can be life-threatening. Ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome. Otherwise known as OHSS, ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome is a rare complication that occurs when too many eggs develop in the ovaries, which can lead to the ovaries becoming swollen and very painful. This usually occurs with injectable hormone medications and a week or two after the medications has been taken. If you have abdominal pain, vomiting, rapid weight gain, shortness of breath, or any other symptoms, then you should seek help urgently, as you need to be monitored and may have to stop your treatment depending on the severity. Now the C word. Cancer. Does IVF really cause cancers? Well, several studies have been done on this, and you can check the links on my description page below. Studies have shown an increased risk of setting cancers with IVF treatment, while conversely, other studies do not show any evidence of increased risk, so this has to be taken into account. For instance, IVF has been linked with slightly increased risk of breast cancers, especially if over the age of 40, and with other risk factors, while another study did not find any evidence of increased breast cancer risk. No increased risks have been found with ovarian or womb cancer, but there has been a slightly increased risk with borderline ovarian tumours, especially in those who have had several rounds of progesterone supplements. These are abnormal cells that form in the tissue covering the ovary and are not cancerous but have the potential to become cancerous, so they're usually removed by surgery. There was a recent story about a woman with a pre-existing brain tumour called a meningioma who had noticed that her otherwise slow-growing tumour had suddenly increased to the size of an orange following several rounds of IVF. Happily, she had a successful surgery and a healthy child. IVF has been shown to slightly increase the risk of childhood cancers, blood cancers like leukemia, liver tumours and solid tumours. A study showed that after 5 years of follow-up, 321 out of 275,686 kids developed cancer. This is approximately 1 in 900 kids, and that's compared with 1 in 1100 in a study of 2 million kids without IVF. The reason why IVF babies are predisposed to childhood cancers is not yet clear. More research is needed into the links between IVF and cancers, which usually involves long-term follow-ups and large population sizes, as well as other risk factors to be taken into account. So it's difficult to prove that some of these cancers are directly due to IVF. Other risks of IVF, whether single or multiple births, include premature births, miscarriages, birth defects, and IVF pregnancy is always a high-risk pregnancy, especially with older age women, and needs close monitoring. The impact on the physical and mental health to both couples, but especially to the mother, who has to go through all the pain of multiple injections, embryo rejection, negative pregnancy tests, cannot be understated. The good news is that IVF technology has advanced in leaps and bounds over the years, and drugs are more kinder and less aggressive to the system, with successful results in a lot of cases. So if you are thinking of having IVF, do not be put off by the risks, but be informed and have a discussion with your partner and a specialist if the benefits outweigh the risks. Also, IVF is not the be-all and end-all. If you do not end up with a pregnancy, there are other options you can consider, such as donor eggs, surrogacy, or adoption. Or you might just decide that it's not meant to be. Whatever happens, it is very important to have the right people around to support you, as IVF, whether failure or successful in the end, can be a traumatic process. If you'd like to hear and watch more videos on health topics such as this, then kindly subscribe to my page by clicking on the subscribe button.